mini cut, and I'll now transition to that off-season period. So, for example, like the story of Wade, 232.4, so a nice steady body composition, still in check. So, really just wait to push now, goals for 250.
Yeah, 240, 250. Same body composition, stay lean, not as fat as last time.
Especially, yeah, don't get as fat as fuck. Just stay in a good position, and it's basically more to strength. So, using like the biggest variable manager is a shame in the gym performance. So, which is everyone should be. Body composition, you can check, but make sure that strength performance is just as good and progressing as well, numbers each week. So, yeah, Charlie is just going to a mini cup.
I've just gone to a mini cup for 4 to 6 weeks. I did about a 16-week push up and weight, got to 274. So now I'm on my way back down, just to clear up before next push up, feel a bit more sensitive, use the carbs better, and more sensitive to everything, including drugs, training, everything. So we're going to hit the ball today, we'll take it for our session. The main compound move is chest quality bar low, and rack pull as well, but we've got rack pull lots, so we're pretty exhausted. We've got about 5 legs, 8 to beat 10.
So basically the reason we do the rack pull last bit, so we're going to do the first, we're going to hit the first, it's just we want our back to be activated. We are trying to train our back today, okay? We're trying to eliminate our hamstrings and glutes, so that's why we're doing our rack pull on the floor, and really to get them firing for so. That's the reason behind that. Obviously, go press those numbers, make sure you get the connection. You know, muscles are actually trying to train. We're not just moving weight from A to B. We are really trying to focus on what we're trying to train. And like I say, just progress those numbers. So we'll necessarily get towards those goals. Just to touch upon, my goal is to get stacks of prices in April next year. So we'll start prepping January for that, start bringing it down.
Yeah.
So these next 4 months, I'm really treating like a prep. So make sure everything is on point. Again, every training session is on point. Just like it would be from January, it's like coming down. As we push it up, I'll make sure I'm just meticulous, I'm just as on it. Because I'm going to show on it. The results will really show.
The prep starts now for January. I've got off season to start with prep as well, so it starts now. You do off season. If you want to do well, then you need to start thinking about that show day for your off season points.
Yeah, exactly. So goals are set. So goals are set in junior, so that'll be well. 23 there, so my last year of juniors, so there's some big goals set, and then obviously the Saxon Classic for the qualifier, hopefully doing pretty well there, and it takes a pretty far to Charlie, you're playing for a bit of a late show?
Yeah, late show, so late qualifier, then on to the finals, maybe two or three shows in total. Yeah, it's pretty much my plans.
Yeah, so it'd be cool to get on stage with the Beer Brothers,
yeah, you've got
the
stage to get
with the juniors, that's pretty unheard of. Pretty cool stuff there. Yeah. So let's get cracking on to the top season as we get in with your blog with him. So I'll talk through as we go. It's your best friend for me, so you know that's nice. So what's up with here is some dual arm pull down. So focus with these on main priority. So think about coming straight down. Okay, so we're not trying to row into it. So see, look at Charlie's plane of motion where his elbows are finishing. They're going straight down. Again, just really fire those lats. Okay.
On this, we're just trying to get that elbow down to the hip. When we're trying to work the function of the lat, we don't want too much scapular retraction. We want the elbow down to the hip, keep our scapula quite retracted, but not much retraction. You see Jake's elbow's going forward, it's not throwing it back. Good man.
Yeah, fine. Basically, how we structure our training, we're quite low volume. Probably good, so we'll do two working sets in this, so it'll be like one loading set, one back off set. The loading set we're really looking to get anywhere sort of six to nine really, and our back off will be 10 plus. Okay, so land within that, and obviously just with the focus of keeping it within our lats. We don't want a bit of position where we're sacrificing form, just to get those extra reps. We want to make sure we're extending the muscle, and we're going to muscular failure here, not just full out failure, swinging the shit out of it, basically. So, yeah, so we'll just work out that. Now basically, jump up the weight, the reps coming down as you do so. Hold on. So for us at the moment, so it's a block chamber just to put where we are. So this is just this is a new rotation for us. So we're just basically trying to set baseline numbers. Like I said at the beginning, we pretty much logbook everything so we make sure we are progressing each time. So today is just easing out where we're at, and then for the next few weeks from there, we'll be then progressing. We're just trying to find baseline numbers today. So it's a bit hit and miss, but let's do the best we can. Right, okay, go ahead. Good, block him in, man, block him in. Good. Okay, come on. Ooh. Yep, in. Go. And again, two. What? Yep. On this, there's a cool down, 8 to 10, then we'll do a back off, in about 12 to 15 after. So get strong at them, different rep ranges, low reps, high reps, get strong at every rep range, and you'll progress. Come on. Five. Go. Two more. Two there. Two there. One more. This is the same. Same four. Come on. Five. Yep. Good. Good. Intro up and halves. Keeps going, especially when we have big boys. Need that energy to get through. Thank you.
talk about today. Hello, Grapples. Today, another top set and a backoff set as well. So, top set, probably 6 to 8 on this. Backoff 10 to 12, would you say? On this, I've got 4 plates and a 15 to me. I think I've got that for about 6 last one. So, yeah, another record man. That's the goal today. Progressive overload. That's how me and Jake train. Always have too many guys, too many pumpy shit training. And look at the same year on year. You've got to get stronger. If you're not getting stronger, you're not progressing.
I mean, just to add to that, if you are not prioritising your training is the most important thing. The reason you go to the gym to start with, okay, that's the first thing that comes to. It should always be the priority. Nutrition, drugs, supplementation, that should all come second, third, fourth. But it should not, your training should always be first. That's how you grow. If your training's off, you won't grow, okay? If you're not progressing week in, week out, month in, month out, year in, year out, you will not grow, okay? You need to make sure you are fucking training hard.
Good. Bit of chop. Close to grip to drive our elbow further back. So before we're going a bit wider, so the elbow's coming out from the back. Remember, if you want to train your upper back, elbows out, relax, elbows down and back towards the hip.
As you see from there, we're not doing 10 reps all about. We're not trying to tire ourselves, we're not trying to fatigue, we're trying to be as fresh as we can for these working sets now, okay? So, we're along with the progressive overload, along with the low volume, with the two working sets, is everything for those two working sets, okay? We're trying to hit better within those set rep ranges. So if we're doing that before that, on the increments on the way up, it's not gonna be optimal. We're not gonna be able to lift as much as we would, okay? So it's really just netting this, and make sure it's so as the weight's coming up, the reps coming down. And our last few warm-ups will be like 2-3 reps. Okay, it's not gonna be a lot. We're not looking to burn out, we're gonna be fresh for those top sets. That's been alright, yeah?
Yeah,
that's
good.
Yeah, that's good, that one.
Well, don't forget you need to strap
off. That's right. Ready?
So we're locking left edge and gym. Let's have a good fucking set of kicks to tune on the back. So,
last year or so,
I got this in. This is probably one of the heaviest team our like chest support is ever used. It's fucking, it's very hot. So I've got this. Compared to be hot.
Get through this, not be back.
Simple. Bloody old tool is a bit dead.
Fuck him, let's start him.
Charge going 4 and 10, and I said go with 6 to 10, okay?
Like I said, warm up, keep it for exactly the same muscular failure, I'm just going to fucking shit out of it.
Nah.
Failure is where you grow. If you work within that, push yourself all the way. That's in your own place. Get fired. Head on, man. Let's go. Come on.
3, 2.
Yep. Oh. Okay. Oh, come on. Nice and tight. Perfect. Perfect. Oh, come on. Yep.
Mentally ready to go, we'll go. We're not rushing in the gym, are we? We're not in here for cardio, so just go when we're ready. Just get the breath back.
This is the time where we're loading now. The high rep stuff, the funk will come later. This is the sole focus now is strength, okay? We're trying to progress this strength. Okay? So we're trying to get stronger across the board and really push it. So rest time is important. If I went now to my back set, it would be subpar, it would not be optimal. So we need to make sure enough rest time, I say no timing, and let's go when we're ready. Fast gasping.
That's absolutely gasping.
Freezing on that, fucking enough.
I won't free both. It's
better slow. Dude, that's different.
It's good, yeah. Good stuff. Good.
7 minute Charlie. Especially Charlie being 27 pounds.
Moving on this, we're breathing.
Charlie's there. Oh, it was like a shot point.
One chases the other. Right, let's go to Rackles. Yeah.
The rack will be the ones we want to really load and focus on progressing massively. So I say we just need to rest, you know, have that side, make sure you go and ready.
Cardio is not my strong point. So I have to sit down a lot in sessions.
As long as it's intense in the sets,
it's all that matters, okay? The high rep fluff stuff can come last, but priority now is intensity within the set, not intensity while you're resting, okay? That's a big mistake we make. You don't need to be rushing 30 seconds here or there. Intensity within the set. How you apply yourself in the set, not how you apply yourself sitting down doing fucking. Okay.
Alright, let's go.
Alright, let's
go. None of this above the knee. None of this above the knee. It has to be right in the fucking bit.
Got it.
I feel like you can tie it up there, or just have a slight pause here, type one.
Last one again.
Right, last one, man, let's get it going, come on. Last one. Yep. Tight, good. Come on. Yeah.
So last one, stop. Try to go for a quick break. last one, so 180 last one. My, like I said, my goals were 220 for 7 last time, so it's 220 for 8. So see how it goes.
One rep's enough. You know if it's there after one rep. You know if it's there. So 220 for 8, that's gone. Which one? 2, try. 220. 225,
yeah? Yeah. 225.
Fucking set. Right, this is the fucking one, man. Let's think about it. Come on. One step, one chance, let's go. Come on! Bring that fucking switch down. So, let's go.
Stay tight! Oosh! Oosh!
Up! Good!
Oosh!
Dead! Grab it up!
One more!
Yep! Nice and tight, nice and tight! Back! Up! Chest!
Go to plan. I said the goal there was 220 for 8, but on the 6th rep, it was 5th or 6th, just that little 6th, yard back down, So I think I've got tight glutes because it went a few weeks ago as well. So just probably get it checked out with the physio and maybe a chiropractor to get me aligned again because that feels pretty bad. So it's lower back glute. But yeah, that's a bit of a pain, a bit of a shame, but it is what it is. At least I can still stand up. So that's the lower back loading done for today anyway. So everything now is a bit more upright with chest supported. So should be able to lock in and it shouldn't cause too much strain. But it is what it is. We live and learn. Might have to give lower back loading a little bit of a break for a week or so, 2 weeks, just to get this fully recovered. Yeah, nice. And now the worst part, even with back injury, I'm rocking the plates.
Then I want to become my little fairy on rack up. Let us know, it's a DM.
Yeah, I've got £20 an hour, right? £20 an hour just for each session. Your job title is little bitch, so you'll be called a little bitch. When we want you, we'll wave our magic wand, and you'll be here to answer my legs, little bitch. So long will say, died 226, no more. Also, you won't be able to read this. There's no point in me showing it. It's basically scribbles. But as long as I know what it says, that's the most important thing.
On this, feet back, chest leaning into the pad, so just doing all lats, no off the back, just all lats. Elbows down.
First time I'm back.
Yes. Chest support.
Yeah.
Great. It just feels like, you know when you need your hips like cracking, like your back cracking, it just feels like really pressure.
Top of the back on this again. Same, that's simple again.
Normally,
that's good. Jake's it. Good offer.
Yeah, it's good.
Precious on. Precious on, so you've got to perform. Basically, we are shrugging. Next. The reason we're shrugging is, well, I have fucking shit traps. Tries on good traps, so you can join in and help me out. So, yeah. Just there, on here, just some straight sets, really. More of the tempo, if we hit 10 reps, up the weight, and just work up to a heavy set, and then leave from there. And then after, it's just like an accessory movement, so. Got some rear delts and then biceps. It's nice and simple. And get these big fucking traps. Thank you. how we structure this is going to have a high rep set, and then from there we'll do a loading and then a back. So three sort of working sets. So to get fired up, so 15 to 20 rep set first, loading set, and then get a back off from there. Maybe do a rest pause for the second set. How we structure rest pauses is we'll have a heavier load, and it'll take to failure, so then rest for 15 seconds, failure again. Rest 15 seconds, failure again, so hit three failure points on those. So just a nice intense method, just to mix up towards the end of the session. Going back. So try this internal cue now. If he's pushing his hands out, we're not thinking about going back. We engage a lot. And the back, we try and make it our rhythm. So here, not here. So he's thinking hands out, hands out.
Yeah. Awesome. Good. Two or three on this one, right?
Yeah.
Finish strong.
Redux.
Redux.
One more.
Put it in.
Yep. So, on to biceps now, we're going to start with dual arm drag curl. So I've been doing these sort of for the last 6 months. So six months, sort of really noticed that developing my biceps. Biceps has been a massive weak point for me. And it's still not great, but they're getting there. What this allows you to do is really hold your arms back and lock your elbow in one position. So all this moving is our forearm. We're locking that upper arm in one position. It's really isolating our bicep. And all we're feedback here is chest up high, shoulders back. And bring that forearm up. So our arms staying behind us and we are dragging that weight, okay? No pull for our biceps, no delt at all. Same again, when we hit muscular failure, we'll stop there, okay? Won't try and cheat it up at all. Keep all that tension in your bicep, okay? Same structure, so we'll do a higher rep set now. Get us up to it, and I'll do a loading set. And yeah, an awesome movement, give it a try. Cable dual arm drag curl, one of my favourites. It's awesome, isn't it?
To get the bicep fully short, you're in a shoulder in an extended position, like back here. So get your bicep fully short, it's just challenging the range of motion. After this, we'll basically go from a shoulder extension movement to a shoulder flexion movement to a reach curl. So we're basically training our bicep two different ranges of motion. This is good for bone mass. What we'll do is our high rep set first, and then we'll load on it, because if we go heavy first, we don't really feel the bicep, it's quite a small muscle. So we'll get lots of blood in there first, do our high rep set first, and the heavy stuff.
Thank you. Find our baseline numbers, and I said the next few weeks we'll be pushing to progress those. A little bit annoyed with my rack pull, lower back went a little bit, but stopped at the right time.
Yeah.
I think if I tried to knock out the rep, it would be another story. I think the recording of the video would have stopped there. So I paused from there, I still walk, still get about around. So it's still too bad, it was just rest up and recover. So tomorrow, my shoulders and arms.
Tomorrow, yeah.
And then some rest, and then some legs on Friday. So yeah, no, really, really good session. So yeah, just looking to push up from there, and then we'll get a few more of these in. We'll probably, I reckon, push your legs next.
Yeah.
On the video.
Maybe a good leg session.
Show you how to train legs properly. Yeah. Show you how to grow some proper legs.
Thanks to Big Ash and Mitch from Definition Gym. If you're in the Peterborough area, check it out. Sick gym.
It's also the best round here by Mark. So if you wanna, if you're serious about training around Cambridgeshire area, Peterborough way, get down there. We travelled half an hour to get here, so it's worth the journey.
Definitely worth it if you're serious about training.
100%. So get down there, give it a go. But yeah, big up.